Welcome to my channel, Technical Arcoen. I hope you will enjoy my videos. Today's topic, interface in Java. So, go for it. Now, today's topic, interface in Java. Okay? And what is an interface? An interface is a completely 100% abstract class. It is similar to a class with collection of abstract methods. Okay? So, what will be the syntax of an interface? So, it will be like that. Interface, next, interface name. Okay? Next, we are defining the members, static, final, and next we are write suppose the data type and the variable name and equal to constant, and the method will be like that: abstract, public, and the method should have some return type, and the method name, and there should be no body, only the declaration is there. Okay, now go for the example, it's better for that. So what will be the example like that? Interface, suppose we take interface name is humanity, and we are declaring a constant, static, final, int, a equal to 10. And we are declaring an abstract method, abstract, public, void, suppose define get data, and there is no body. Okay, and also we can define this particular syntax, example in different way also. How? Interface humanity. And we are defining simple int a equal to 10, and we are declaring simple public void get data. Okay, that means by default, if we not given static or final here, by default it is static final. If the method is not given abstract, implicitly it's an abstract. Okay. Now we can continue this example, means either we take this or we take this, okay, any one we take. After that, we are implement the interface in a class. Suppose the class name is kind, and we are implements humanity. Okay, and then what happened? Now we are just write the body of the method, which is an abstract. Public void, and we are write get data. Okay, and we are simple write a statement system dot out dot println, and we are just print the value of a. Okay, and there is a driver class which will instantiate the object of the class kind. So suppose the class name is driver. And we all know we need a main method, that's why public static void main, and we are defining string and args. Okay, and now you create an object. Okay, the object of the derived class should be created. After that, there is a class kind. Okay, and we create an object, suppose name is s1, and how you can create the object? Just equal new and give the class name kind, first bracket open close semicolon, and we call the method which is name get data, and how you can call s1.getData. Okay, now what happened? Now this is an interface, either you can write this syntax or you can write this
syntax anyone can use, and after that we write this part. So there is an interface which contain one constant variable A and another abstract method get data, and this abstract method body is declared within the class where the interface implements. Okay, and we never create object of the interface, means we never instantiate the interface. So that's why what happened, the class kind should create the object, means the instantiation of the derived class should done. So that's why we are creating the object of the class kind, and through this object we can access the method name getData. Now we give this two diagram. One diagram is given that suppose there is a class A and another class B, and both class as the base class. Okay, now what happened, we want the class A and B will extends both in a class C. So this is a derived class. Actually this feature is known as multiple inheritance. This feature is exist within the C++ language, but Java doesn't support it. Should remember, I again repeat, these features, multiple inheritance through classes, is never supported in Java. So that's why the interface is actually introduced, means where more than one class is not extend in a single class, but more than one interface can implements in a single class. Okay, so this is a multiple inheritance is done implicitly in Java using interface. And what will be the syntax like that? Class C, so this is a class, that's why class C. Okay, and we are implements these two interface, so interface A comma B, and after that we are write the body of the class in that case. Okay, so this should be remembered, because we know that Java does not support multiple inheritance, but through interface we can implement it implicitly. Okay, and next some point should be remembered when we are using interface. The first point is that a class can implement more than one interface. So this is the example. Okay, number two, a class can extends only one class but implements many interfaces. So if we write an example or a diagram like that, suppose A, B, C, these are three different part is given, and another class suppose D, where A is your interface, B is your interface, and C is your class. It can possible in Java. Why? Because more than one interface can implements within a single class, but only one class can extend, not more than one class. So this is your derived class. Okay, and number three, an interface can extend another interface in a similar way as class can extend another class, means interface, one interface can also extend within the another interface like a class. Means if A is an interface, then it can be derived within the another interface. So then we are using the extends keywords. I mean, this is your actually derived and this is your base interface. I hope you understand this topic. So thank you.